What are micronutrients? The term micronutrients is used to describe vitamins and minerals in general. Macronutrients, on the other hand, include proteins, fats and carbohydrates. Your body needs smaller amounts of micronutrients relative to macronutrients. That's why they're labeled micro. Micronutrients are one of the major groups of nutrients your body needs. They include vitamins and minerals. Vitamins are necessary for energy production, immune function, blood clotting and other functions. Meanwhile, minerals play an important role in growth, bone health, fluid balance and several other processes. Humans must obtain micronutrients from food since your body cannot produce vitamins and minerals for the most part. That's why they're also referred to as essential nutrients. Vitamins are organic compounds made by plants and animals which can be broken down by heat, acid or air. On the other hand, minerals are inorganic, exist in soil or water and cannot be broken down. When you eat, you consume the vitamins that plants and animals created or the minerals they absorbed. The micronutrient content of each food is different, so it's best to eat a variety of foods to get enough vitamins and minerals. An adequate intake of all micronutrients is necessary for optimal health, as each vitamin and mineral has a specific role in your body. Vitamins and minerals are vital for growth, immune function, brain development and many other important functions. Depending on their function, certain micronutrients also play a role in preventing and fighting disease. Types and functions of micronutrients. Vitamins and minerals can be divided into four categories: water-soluble vitamins, fat-soluble vitamins, macrominerals and trace minerals. Regardless of type, vitamins and minerals are absorbed in similar ways in your body and interact in many processes. Water-soluble vitamins. Most vitamins dissolve in water and are therefore known as water-soluble. They're not easily stored in your body and get flushed out with urine when consumed in excess. While each water-soluble vitamin has a unique role, their functions are related. For example, most B vitamins act as coenzymes that help trigger important chemical reactions. A lot of these reactions are necessary for energy production. The water-soluble vitamins with some of their functions are: vitamin B1, thiamine, helps convert nutrients into energy. Exists in whole grains, meat, fish. Vitamin B2, riboflavin, necessary for energy production, cell function and fat metabolism. Exists in organ meats, eggs, milk. Vitamin B3, niacin, drives the production of energy from food. Exists in meat, salmon, leafy greens, beans. Vitamin B5, pantothenic acid, necessary for fatty acid synthesis. Exists in organ meats, mushrooms, tuna, avocado. Vitamin B6, pyridoxine, helps your body release sugar from stored carbohydrates for energy and create red blood cells. Exists in fish, milk, carrots, potatoes. Vitamin B7, biotin, plays a role in the metabolism of fatty acids, amino acids and glucose. Exists in eggs, almonds, spinach, sweet potatoes. Vitamin B9, folate, important for proper cell division. Exists in beef, liver, black-eyed peas, spinach, asparagus. Vitamin B12, cobalamin, necessary for red blood cell formation and proper nervous system and brain function. Exists in clams, fish, meat. Vitamin C, ascorbic acid, required for the creation of neurotransmitters and collagen, the main protein in your skin. Exists in citrus fruits, bell peppers, Brussels sprouts. Fat-soluble vitamins. Fat-soluble vitamins do not dissolve either. They're best absorbed when consumed alongside a source of fat. After consumption, fat-soluble vitamins are stored in your liver and fatty tissues for future use. The names and functions of fat-soluble vitamins are: vitamin A, necessary for proper vision and organ function. Exists in retinol, liver, dairy, fish, carotenoids, sweet potatoes, carrots, spinach. Vitamin D promotes proper immune function and assists in calcium absorption and bone growth. Exists in sunlight, fish oil, milk. Vitamin E assists immune function and acts as an antioxidant that protects cells from damage. Exists in sunflower seeds, wheat germ, almonds. Vitamin K, required for blood clotting and proper bone development. Exists in leafy greens, soybeans, pumpkin. Macrominerals. Macrominerals are needed in larger amounts than trace minerals in order to perform their specific roles in your body. The macrominerals and some of their functions are: calcium, necessary for proper structure and function of bones and teeth. Assists in muscle function and blood vessel contraction. Exists in milk products, leafy greens, broccoli. Phosphorus, part of bone and cell membrane structure. Exists in salmon, yogurt, turkey. Magnesium assists with over 300 enzyme reactions, including regulation of blood pressure. Exists in almonds, cashews, black beans. Sodium, electrolyte that aids fluid balance and maintenance of blood pressure. Exists in salt, processed foods, canned soup. Chloride, often found in combination with sodium. Helps maintain fluid balance and is used to make digestive juices. Exists in seaweed, salt, celery. Potassium, electrolyte that maintains fluid status in cells and helps with nerve transmission and muscle function. Exists in lentils, acorn squash, bananas. Sulfur, part of every living tissue and contained in the amino acids methionine and cysteine. Exists in garlic, onions, Brussels sprouts, eggs, mineral water. Trace minerals. Trace minerals are needed in smaller amounts than macrominerals but still enable important functions in your body. The trace minerals and some of their functions are: iron, helps provide oxygen to muscles and assists in the creation of certain hormones. Exists in oysters, white beans, spinach. Manganese, assists in carbohydrate, amino acid and cholesterol metabolism. Exists in pineapple, pecans, peanuts. Copper, required for connective tissue formation, as well as normal brain and nervous system function. Exists in liver, crabs, cashews. Zinc, necessary for normal growth, immune function and wound healing. Exists in oysters, crab, chickpeas. Iodine, assists in thyroid regulation. Exists in seaweed, cod, yogurt. Fluoride, necessary for the development of bones and teeth. Exists in fruit juice, water, crab. Selenium, important for thyroid health, reproduction and defense against oxidative damage. Exists in Brazil nuts, sardines, ham. Health benefits of micronutrients. All micronutrients are extremely important for the proper functioning of your body. Consuming an adequate amount of the different vitamins and minerals is key to optimal health and may even help fight disease. This is because micronutrients are part of nearly every process in your body. Moreover, certain vitamins and minerals can act as antioxidants. Antioxidants may protect against cell damage that has been associated with certain diseases, including cancer, Alzheimer's, and heart disease. For example, research has linked an adequate dietary intake of vitamins A and C with a lower risk of some types of cancer. Getting enough of some vitamins may also help prevent Alzheimer's disease. A review of 7 studies found that adequate dietary intake of vitamin C, C and A is associated with a 24%, 17% and 12% reduced risk of developing Alzheimer's, respectively. Certain minerals may also play a role in preventing and fighting disease. Research has linked low blood levels of selenium to a higher risk of heart disease. A review of observational studies found that the risk of heart disease decreased by 24% when blood concentrations of selenium increased by 50%. Additionally, a review of 22 studies noticed that adequate calcium intake decreases the risk of death from heart disease and all other causes. These studies suggest that consuming enough of all micronutrients, especially those with antioxidant properties, provides ample health benefits. However, it's unclear whether consuming more than the recommended amounts of certain micronutrients either from foods or supplements offers additional benefits. Micronutrient deficiencies and toxicities. Micronutrients are needed in specific amounts to perform their unique functions in your body. Getting too much or too little of a vitamin or mineral can lead to negative side effects. Deficiencies. Most healthy adults can get an adequate amount of micronutrients from a balanced diet, but there are some common nutrient deficiencies that affect certain populations. These include vitamin D. Approximately 77% of Americans are deficient in vitamin D, mostly due to lack of sun exposure. Vitamin B12, vegans and vegetarians may develop vitamin B12 deficiency from refraining from animal products. Elderly individuals are also at risk due to decreased absorption with age. Vitamin A. The diets of women and children in developing countries often lack adequate vitamin A. Iron, deficiency of this mineral is common among preschool children, menstruating women and vegans. Calcium, close to 22% and 10% of men and women over 50, respectively, don't get enough calcium. The signs, symptoms and long-term effects of these deficiencies depend on each nutrient but can be detrimental to the proper functioning of your body and optimal health. Toxicities. Micronutrient toxicities are less common than deficiencies. They are most likely to occur with large doses of the fat-soluble vitamins A, D, E and K, since these nutrients can be stored in your liver and fatty tissues. They cannot be excreted from your body like water-soluble vitamins. A micronutrient toxicity usually develops from supplementing with excess amounts, rarely from food sources. Signs and symptoms of toxicity vary depending on the nutrient. It's important to note that excessive consumption of certain nutrients can still be dangerous even if it does not lead to overt toxicity symptoms. One study examined over 18,000 people with a higher risk of lung cancer due to past smoking or asbestos exposure. The intervention group received 2 types of vitamin A, 30 mg of beta-carotene and 25,000 mg of retinyl palmitate a day. The trial was halted ahead of schedule when the intervention group showed 28% more cases of lung cancer and a 17% greater incidence of death over 11 years compared to the control group. Micronutrient supplements. The safest and most effective way to get adequate vitamin and mineral intake appears to be from food sources. More research is needed to fully understand the long-term effects of toxicities and supplements. However, people at risk of specific nutrient deficiencies may benefit from taking supplements under the supervision of a doctor. If you're interested in taking micronutrient supplements, look for products certified by a third party. Unless otherwise directed by a healthcare provider, be sure to avoid products that contain super or mega doses of any nutrient. If you like our video, get your thumbs up, subscribe and hit that bell icon to stay in touch. Have a nice and healthy day.